With blade, speaks the loudest!
Oh my god, did you see his arm go flying off the screen? We just took more of his arms off.
There's never ascension from those sacks. Worthless limbs be gone! That old Taoist fooled me. My challenge was a delusion. Forget it! Face me in a fair fight. You shall learn to best that corruption.
What, he's full health? My cooldowns are coming up. You want to keep buying time? I'm okay with that. Something getting unveiled on the wall. It's a Wookiee! Hi, Neof. Until it used to be an adventurer like you until I took a bow staff to the kneecap. gold tree core. Is this, like, gonna pull me in? Like, we've seen paintings that pulled me into the paintings. I like how he just pauses for a moment. He's like, this isn't the weirdest thing I've seen today. And then he just goes in. I love this guide. So I didn't read the description for the fight before fighting it because I wanted to fight it blind. I just used this wiki page to find the location. But it reads, this fight has two phases. The first is pretty much a carbon copy of the first encounter with the Venom Taoist. He's very easy to bully. In the second phase, he loses his extra arms and somehow becomes more powerful as a result. Somehow. All right. Let's see. Okay, since I've encountered a new area, I'm not gonna keep reading the bosses I missed list. We'll just go check this out and see what we find. Also, I noticed my flask is full again. Purple Cloud Mountain. This is like a whole area I didn't find.
Husband. Oh dear.
Is that a snake whining?
Kind passerby might find your remains. Young master, please forgive my impropriety. I am but a widow, here to mourn my late husband. Show some kindness and excuse my manners. We lived in peace in our mountaintop home. But out of nowhere, wicked insects swarmed the place. They occupied our village. I was the lone survivor. I intended to retrieve my late husband's keepsakes. But the Gwai's leader, the Scorpion Lord, has discouraged all my attempts with his death sting.
Okay. She say the Scorpion Lord? We have fought a few scorpion-ish mini-bosses. No bosses, though.
Are you heading up the mountain? Venomous Yaoguais have infested the forest ahead. Take caution, or you may never make it back alive. Remember to carry enough herbs with you, in case you find yourself poisoned.
I think you mean venomed. Poison means I would have to eat the enemy.
Are you heading up the mountain?
Okay, we've exhausted the young lady's dialogue.
The forest ahead. Take caution. You may never make it back alive.
I'll see if there's anything new here since we just killed the frog and the venom Taoist. Nope. No pings. Alright. There's usually a red dot next to any section that has new stuff, but that is not the case this time. Okay, we've got left and right. All right, so from that shrine, we have cross bridge and we have left and right options. Oh my God, it's a tree man! We're in the wood elf lands. Oh no. Got it. That was a lot of fun. But I'm out of stamina. Oh, there was a lot of other things hitting me. Wait, oh, that one had a blue soul. I didn't realize I was fighting a buffed up one. So that gives us a shapeshift. I don't know if it's any good, but it gives us a shapeshift. She was like, you might get poisoned on the mountain, and then friggin' everything is poisoning me. Oh no! Hmm. Sometimes it's hard to tell in this game if something is meant to be climbable or if I'm just like trying to force my way climbing up something that's not meant to be climbed. Okay, that was meant to be. Mmm, shiny. Gold Sun Crow Curio. Golded Carp moderately increases the chance of obtaining materials from defeated enemies. Slightly increases damage bonus. 1%! You can see it over on the right-hand side. This effect is enhanced when equipped with Jade Moon Rabbit. Considerably increased crit hit chance when health is low. Where's the new spirit? Right here. Snake Herbalist. Recover a small amount of health when taking medicines. Take the form of the snake herbalist, smash venom on the ground from the herb basket to form poisonous pools. Those that step in the pools will stack poison vein. Demo. So they go out at like a mid-range. Probably not going to use that. Interesting though. Using this gourd grants a moderate amount of burn resistance and immunity from lava terrain for a short duration. I don't know that I've seen lava terrain, but that's the second thing I've seen that protects you from it, which has me a little worried about the future. We got lava on the horizon. I'm currently thinking of... Oh, I should have used the charge of the class first. I'm currently thinking about... There was some level in Monster Hunter World where like I had to get like a cool drink in order to... like survive on the level. It was so hot. Let's do this. Mug for Halloween this year, I'm gonna dress up as a first-time chatter who comes in to spoil the story. Oh god, it's an average Black Myth Wukong viewer. I have actually, it's kind of shocking, really, because I play a lot of games, right? We counted 85 last year. There's gonna be less this year because I've spent 400 hours playing Total War. But I play a lot of different games. Hands down. The one that has the most people just pop into chat like, oh, why haven't you MacGuffin? And I'm just like, oh my god. Like, has absolutely been this one. Another curio, Celestial Registry. Slightly increases XP from defeating enemies. It's probably like 1%. Tree seed. Emma, you don't gotta play the expansion on Monster Hunter. There's also the ice island where you need hot drink. Oh, great. I'm so sad I missed out on having to spam hot drinks.
Hello.
It's been long since any soul has trodden these hidden bounds. Hail, young master. Your face is gaunt, complexion sallow.
No, I'm a monkey.
Both remind me of the venom's touch. Has the worm also beset you? An oddity thrives here. The armor worm.
Oh, I beat
Consuming
him.
Consuming its eggs grants great power. Yet once the larvae hatch, they devour your insides, leaving an undying husk.
I'm glad I didn't eat its eggs.
My fellow disciples, hungry for power, consumed those eggs. And now, most are beyond remedy. Young master, if you will, end their suffering in my stead. They were my fellows. I can't.
Okay. Need to exhaust his
their
dialogue.
Lifeless bodies might still bear eggs unhatched. Bring those eggs to me, and perhaps I can find a cure. Young master, have you found my fellows? Just a reminder, they oft wander amidst the village. May you find some luck there. Their lifeless bodies might still bear eggs.
What was the other game? There's no game or something.
Bring those eggs to me. And perhaps I can
maybe it's just not fresh in my head. If it happened with that, I just can't recall it. It was pretty crazy though with Black Myth Wukong. It was just like, you know, 10 people in a day, like every 5 minutes. I was just like, are you guys for real? I felt like I was getting punked or something. I don't even know what this guy's charged heavy attack does, because it takes like 6 weeks shipping to show up. There we go. Okay, a little lunge. We in chapter 5 now? I have started chapter 5, but then I went back to chapter 4 with a list of bosses to hunt down the ones that I missed. So, like, I like to play the chapter no spoilers and see what all I can find. And then afterward, go back through it with a list of the stuff I missed. And that's what I'm doing right now. So, right now, I am in an area that I never found on my own. And, whoa! And I am hunting, somewhere in here is a boss I never found. Obviously, because I never found this area. Muck, which chapter did you like the most until now? I don't know. They've all been good. I mean, maybe I very slightly disliked the one that chapter 4 with all the caves of spiders more than the others, because so much of it looked alike. It was, like, hard to tell where I was. So just from the perspective of someone who is getting lost often, I didn't like it as much. But it was like a very small dislike, you know? It was still great. I'm definitely gonna buy this game. Troy, it's a good game, Troy. I really enjoyed it. What about boss fight? I do have some boss fights I disliked more than others. Okay, for me, the toughest boss fights in the game, and okay, I will try to be a little vague here, but I have to give us some details to answer the question because I don't want to spoil people who don't want it. The toughest boss fights to me are the ones that just took away something you've had until that time. There was a fight with a guy that had controlled sandstorms. And there was constantly just like a film of sand all over my screen. I couldn't see script. Now I found out later there was an optional quest that I never found that takes away his ability to do that. If I had done that, that would have been better, but I never found it. The second one that I disliked was you were fighting a guy and you were in a giant mud pit. And so your movement was really slow. And also if you dodged, you had to wait like 3 seconds before you could dodge again. Normal in this game is like there's a half second break between dodges. So it was, you had to really plan out your dodges because you got like one dodge every 3 or 4 seconds. So it'd make the fight much more challenging. And then the last one was the final boss of chapter 4, which he puts a seal on you during the fight. And your maximum stamina is half of what it normally is. And because of that, you could only do like 3 attacks and a dodge or something, and then you would be completely out of stamina. Also, your ability to shapeshift was 100% taken away. You couldn't do that at all. And like there was just a bunch of this. So basically just like those fights that were just like they took away from you rather than just presented you a challenge. I really didn't care for those compared to the others. So I was less fond of those. My favorite fight so far was actually one that, I don't know if it's true or not. Someone in chat told me that a lot of people in the community think it's one of the toughest fights in the game. It was the Yellow Long, like one of those dragon men. And I fought him last night, and it took me over an hour, but I killed him. And it felt very satisfying. And he didn't, like, you know, gimp your abilities or anything like that. You can do whatever you want. But he's just a really tough fight. But it had a certain flow to it that felt really, really good. Like, you know, it was like, you know, he would, like, it was very much a memorize his attack patterns, right? Like, when he would start to pull back, I'd be like, okay, he's about to lunge through me, he's going to spin around, then this spin is going to leave an electric field, it's going to explode, and he's going to lunge at me again. So I'd be like, all right, dodge, wait, dodge, dodge backward, wait, dodge. Okay, I can hit him 3 times, and it was like, it was almost like once I had memorized his attack patterns, it was like a dance back and forth. And it was really fun. I very much enjoyed it. And he didn't, you know, cover my screen in sand or take away my ability to dodge or anything. I just had to get good. What's in the box? Life-saving pill formula. Whoa! Hello.
A monk.
How did you know what you missed in previous chapter again? There is... So, someone sent me a website, and, hang on. Okay, first off, I will tell you, if you don't want spoilers, don't click this link. This is a link that someone else in my chat sent me. It's one of those random video game websites like PC Gamer, and it's a list of all the bosses that have been found in the game so far. And at the beginning of the list is a link for Chapter 1, Chapter 2, Chapter 3, yeah, etc., etc. And so, what I did was I beat the act and found what I found. Then I looked at the list. It was like, all right, who do I not recognize on this list? And whenever we found something I didn't recognize, we followed the directions on there and hunted it down. Because for me, the most fun in this is the bosses, so I wanted to find them all. And some of them were just like slightly out of the way and I barely missed them. And some of them were really obscure. Like you had to go stand in some corner and hop on one foot and sing happy birthday on leap year at midnight. And then it made the boss spawn on like in Alabama. And it was just like, okay. So some of it was really obscure. Dang it. Why do I even try to pick these things anymore? It's always these things. At least this one's weaker than the last one. Oh, I just heard the jingle. Oh, that wasn't too hard to find. I'm asking because there might be some bosses that could be missable. Since you're reading guides to find bosses, I assume you wouldn't want to miss the bosses. I mean, it's kind of that way in... Okay, so this game is not entirely a Souls-like, but it has a lot of overlap with Souls-like games. And if you've ever played a Souls-like game, there is a ton of optional bosses, right? Like, there will be a guy in town, and if you do the right sequence of events, he becomes a boss, and you lose him as a merchant. You know, like, he gets mad at you because you killed his brother, and you didn't even know it was his brother. Like, there's crap like that. So, there's situations like that in this. Like, if you do certain events, you can find someone and then fight them, and then they run away at 10% health, and then you fight them a second time. If you go back to an area you've already been, you fight them there, and then when they die, they're like, "Et tu, Brutus," and then a portal to hell opens, and you could step to the portal, and that's kind of how I ended up here. I stepped through a painting that was revealed when I killed a guy that I missed, and now there's a whole nother freaking level here. So like, they do that a lot. Now, are they essential for the story? No. If it's something that you can miss, it's not essential for the story. But it you know, it's another experience that you can enjoy if you wish, and I wish to. All right, so there's stairs going up there. Let me look over here first. Fruit of Dao. Poisoned. Missable, as if you kill bosses in a different order, some would just disappear. I haven't seen any like that in this game. I have seen stuff like that in Souls games. It's like in Souls games, it's like if you kill Fred before you do Bob's quest, Bob will just leave and you'll never see him again. You know, and then if you don't have Bob there, you can't fight Sam the Unclean or something like that. Yeah, that is a thing. I haven't seen that gimmick in this game yet. That's not to say it's not here. There is one single boss I tried to go to, you know, later, just minutes ago on this list, and it was bugged. And hopefully they patch it, or, you know, I could always, you know, find it in New Game Plus. But there was basically an item I needed to interact with. There was four items I had to interact with to summon a boss. And one of the items, the interact button's not there. So, little glitch there. That is the only problem I have found in coming back from these in the wrong order.